It's dark, it's late, and perhaps even a little scary. So you pull out your Infinity X1 emergency tool, which includes a 200 lumen flashlight. So you press the power button, and you blind yourself with the 500 lumen work light. Since you are unable to see, you did not notice the attacking bear. And he eats you for dinner. Perhaps that's overly dramatic, but that's to highlight a critical design flaw of this product. It's just one switch that controls so many things. And pressing it when all of the lights are off triggers the brightest mode, typically right towards your eyeballs. Makers of flashlights need to stop doing this. Seriously, have you ever used the low setting on a flashlight? Perhaps, as that could conserve power. But what about the strobe light? While that seems like it might be a handy feature in an emergency, or perhaps a dance club, it's usually just in the way when I want a normal flashlight. I started wondering if something happened that caused switches to become more expensive. Why can't they just have separate buttons for separate features? Yet, a local Dollar Tree store had this 150 lumens work light for $1.25. It has a very basic switch, on, off, on, off. Very simple. Why can't the Infinity X1 be that simple? The intention of this video, or Photix TV in general, is not to be overly critical. Yet, the Infinity X1 is more expensive. Is it worth the extra money? Well, when this video was created, the Infinity X1 was on sale for $17. That's $8 less than the listed $25 online price. It was even cheaper when purchased at a Costco warehouse. Also, there are numerous advantages to the Infinity X1. First, it's something of an alternative to a road flare. With the magnetic bottom and a bright red light, it can help alert other drivers if you have to park your car on the side of the road. The light can be set to red and flashing red. I think I prefer a bright LED light to a road flare, as now that I think about it, I've been driving around with the same road flare for over 2 decades. I'm not sure if it still works, and I can't test it as easily as the X1. Although, if you're using the Infinity X1 as a warning light, then it's not available as a work light. Fortunately, the package included 2 emergency tools, so that's nice. Each X1 also includes a seatbelt cutter and a pointy metal tip for smashing windows. Photix TV doesn't have the budget for testing such things. But I figure the X1 is probably better than using my bare hands. That's the main purpose of the Infinity X1. It's designed towards automotive-related emergencies. So, while I haven't tested this device in an emergency, it's a nice feeling having it in the car. I have tested the X1 in the house, though. The magnet is really strong, as it sticks to the side of the refrigerator. The $1.25 light from the Dollar Tree could not handle the same test. It slid right down. Although it would stay in place on the textured side of the fridge. Both gadgets are good work lights. So, what do I think of the Infinity X1? I think it's nice. It's just too bad that it doesn't have a more useful light switch.